Hi, let us discuss the concept called start activity for result. Then create one project name start activity for result. The start activity for result concept we are going to use to get the result back from call activity. That means which activity you are calling, that may be implicit using implicit intent or explicit intent. Implicit intent we are using to call inbuilt in applications, and explicit intent we are using to call the explicit activities from the same application only, right? So here the start activity for result concept we are using to get the result back from which activity you are calling. From there you can get the result back to your activity. For that only Android is providing the mechanism called start activity for result mechanism. That means instead of start activity method, you are calling start activity for result. Clearly in the programming you will observe what is happening. I am changing this layout to linear layout. Right. I am taking one button here. Button ID I am going to say, suppose from this activity, first activity, that is this main activity, I'm going to give one option choose phone number, and I'm going to call second activity. There I'm going to display number of phone numbers, but out of that phone, suppose I'm going to display five phone numbers, I'm choosing only one phone number. For that we can use a radio buttons concept. You will see that. So ID I'm going to take choose phone number button. For this concept, if you want to understand, first you need to have the knowledge in the concept of radio buttons and group, radio group. Clear knowledge you need to have. Right. Text I'm going to give choose phone number. Right. This is first activity, and for second activity we need to create one more XML layout. That one I'm going to say XML name choose phone number XML file. And here I am going to display a multiple phone numbers. Let me take 4 or 5 phone numbers. And radio group I am taking, right? Remember, you should not take individual radio buttons, right? All the radio buttons what you are going to take, inside radio group only you need to take the radio buttons. So here I am giving the ID for radio group is phone number radio group. And why we are taking the radio group, in the sense, if you are taking the individual radio buttons, at a time you can select multiple radio buttons, but the radio button concept is out of suppose more than one radio button, if you have, just you can select only one radio button. Out of many options, only one option you can choose. That is a radio button concept normally we are using. For you observe, when you're going to register in multiple websites, for gender concept you are going to use choosing male or female. So here I'm taking 4 radio buttons. And here radio buttons IDs are not that much important. Radio group ID is very important. So let me change just to this one to radio ID is 2, 3 radio H. And phone numbers I'm going to display 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. Just the sample phone numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. Saving that one. Right. No need to give any buttons like send or submit, all these things. Why? Because obviously if you are choosing one radio button, automatically that is going to send the result back to the call activity. We'll see that one. I'm going to defaultly one radio button is checking. I'm not going to allow that option. So I'm going to delete that one. Delete that option. That is the second XML file layout. So for that, we need to create one more Java file for second activity. So let us create a new Java file saying that choose phone number. So here we know how to create activity. Right. So every class here, if you are saying activity, that should extends with activity. Sorry. Extends with activity class. Activity, and instead we need to take onCreate method. Why? Because onCreate method is going to create your activity, and instead we need to call setContainer method and XML file reference need to call, that is a choose phone number. And okay, fine. We created a second activity, that is choose phone number activity, right? From main activity only, we are going to call the choose phone number activity, and from choose phone number activity, we are getting the result back to main activity. The result is what? You are going to choose one phone number, right? So first of all, here, when we are going to perform this action, right? In the main activity, you are going to click on the choose phone number button, then you are going to start the choose phone number activity. From there, you are going to get the result back to main activity, right? So first of all, we need to call the button in the main activity. I'm going to call the button class. That means we need to call the reference, right? I'm going to suggest choose phone number btn. I'm going to make this one as a global, that is a instance variable, right? Equal to button and find you by id or dot id dot. We have given unique id for the button choose phone number. After that, we need to write the action for this button dot set on click listener and new on click listener. Import the packages. Right, so normally if you want to call other activity here, till now we are going to call one method start activity. In that we are going to pass intent object, that is going to define which activity you should call, that is explicit activity. So here, instead of start activity, we are going to call start active for result method. Now see, I'm going to define first of all intent object, intent in equal to new intent of get application context, and we need to call choose phone number activity, so choose phone number dot class. And here we need to call which method, start activity for result. Here you will see the start activity for result, you have the two parameters. One is intent object, that already we are having the intent object, and second parameter request code, right? Why? Because at a time you can call, sorry, from one activity you can call multiple start activity for results. So that's why we need to take one unique request code. Unique request code. And why? Because you can call multiple activities to get the result back. That's why how we are going to clarify the result you're getting from which activity. For that sake only, request code we are going to take. So I'm going to, request code is integer, then I'm going to say int, right, choose ph request equal to 1. So here we need to use intent object, and the next one request code already we created, that is choose phone request, right? And okay, fine, using the start activity result you're calling choose phone number, but here one more method we need to override to hold the result. It's going to hold the result from which activity you are getting the result. So in current activity, it's going to hold the result. So that the method we are going to say on activity result method. Just you are going to override that method. In this method, you will see the parameters, into request code what we are passing, and result code we are getting from which activity you are calling. From there, we are going to get the result code, and intent data is going to hold the result from called activity. Right, fine. So now we need to go for the choose phone number activity. Here we need to set the result. That means what? Implicitly, it's not going to return the result. You need to write the code in the choose phone number activity to send the result back to the main activity. Now let us see how we are going to write that code. First of all, we need to call the radio group rg equal to radio group and find you by id or dot id dot, you can say phone number radio group. And rg dot, I can write the programming set on checker change listener. Here I'm going to say this, right? We need to implement the interface on checker change listener. After that, we need to add the unimplemented method from that on checker change listener interface. So here we need to write the code. which radio button you are selecting. That means which phone number you are selecting, that one we need to send back to main activity. That is only the concept. Start activity for result, getting the result back from which activity you are calling, right? So first of all, I need to get the, in that radio group we are displaying 4 or 5 radio buttons. Which radio button is selecting, that radio button ID we need to get here. So I'm going to take int ID equal to Archie dot, right, let us make this one as a final. So this is also not working, sorry. ఏనో కొంచెం సౌండ్ తగ్గించు. ఆర్జి డాట్ గెట్ హైన మెథడ్ గెట్ చెక్ రేడియో బటన్ ఐడి రైట్. హియర్ ఫ్రమ్ రేడియో బటన్ వీఆర్ కటింగ్ వన్ మెథడ్ కాల్ గెట్ చెక్ రేడియో బటన్ ఐడి. దిస్ మెథడ్ ఈస్ గోన్ టు రిటర్న్ రైట్ హియర్ వీఆర్ గోన్ టు డిస్ప్లే how many radio buttons? 4 radio buttons. Which radio button you are selecting, that ID is going to getting exactly using one method called get check radio button ID. So now I'm going to call the radio button. Already you know this programming. Without knowing all these things, you cannot go for the start activity for result concept. I'm going to call the radio button and find you by ID, or here just you are going to call the ID. See, check radio button ID we are getting, and we are going to store into this integer variable, that only I am passing here. Now simple, I am get the text. Why? Because check radio button we are getting, from that radio button we can get the text what you binded to that radio buttons. So I am going to say phone number equal to rb dot get text dot to string. Now this one we need to send to the which activity? Main activity. Right, first we need to create intent object. Intent in equal to new intent. Otherwise this one you can say data. Why? Because from here you are going to create the intent object. In that intent only we are going to store the data. That one we are sending to the main activity. The main activity in the on activity result method, this intent object is going to get the data from call activity. So choose phone number. And after that, in the intent, we need to store, right? So data dot put, that one is a string format. So put extra of string name and character value. Just I'm going to say phone number, right? And value is what? PH number. And we need to call one method, set result method. Set result. The set result will see result code. I'm going to say result okay, and data object on intent object. And after that I'm going to call finish method. Why? Because after selecting the radio button, automatically you're going to destroy this activity and sending the result to the main activity. Save. And after that, let's get back to the main activity. Here just I'm going to check the condition, right, from which activity I'm getting the data, right? If request code equal to, request code is what now? Choose phone number request code. Equal to choose phone number request code. And again I'm going to check one more condition. You are getting the result correctly or not. That's why again result code, that one. Result code equal to the choose phone number what we have given. Result okay. That only we need to check. If result is not coming back, then one more predefined constant is coming. That is what? Result cancelled. That is for implicit intents. If you are calling the implicit intents, in the sense inbuilt in applications, automatically it's going to result return result cancelled. If it is not returning the result cancelled will come. If it is returning the result okay will come. Now there we have taken result okay. Now in this situation only we need to get the data. Now string ph number, there we are showing the phone number, which phone number you are selecting, that only we need to get here. So who is going to hold the data? Intent object is going to. So there put extra here, get string extra of, you can say ph number, the key what you stored there. The key we stored is page number H, and after that the same button I'm going to bind the data, that is choose phone number dot set text of ph number, and the choose phone number activity we need to register in the manifest file, and application under application notes add, and we need to select activity. Automatically this application attributes will come. It's taking some processor slow. It's going to search for how many activities are available in our currently in our application. Searching for the activities, need to choose the choose phone number activity and save. After that, run your application. See that output. And for reference, I can go to my blog, that is RAMs Android for all blogspot add-in. There you will find the code, source code. In this blog, just you will see some video tutorials, and under some archive, you will get that one source code. Otherwise, you can go to the core Android concepts. Here, you will get concept by concept. There, you will find started tree for result source code. And you'll see output came. Then, I'm going to click on choose phone number. It is calling this activity. So, I'm going to choose 12345. See, automatically, that result is 12345. What you are selecting. It's coming to the call activity, and here is going to from which activity you started that activity is going to bind the result. So defaultly one radio button is selecting. Let us remove that option, that is this radio button, and checkout option. That's it. And again can rerun, then start activity for result. And here you can go to the core at Android concepts. And under core Android concepts, you will see start activity for result source code. Somewhere else here only. See, getting a result from call activity using start activity for result. Here you will see the report about the how you need to use the syntaxes and about the start activity for result, how to receive the result, and all I have given clearly. You will see one more example source code also. Let's check that output. Choose phone number and see here you need to choose one number. Suppose I'm going to choose this one, automatically the result is coming to this main activity and binding here. So that is the concept of start activity for result. Thank you. We'll meet again in the next video tutorial. Bye.